In this video, I'll show you how to use shot sequencing in DaVinci Resolve for live action replays. Shot sequencing lets you run multiple shots one after the other during a replay. It's all done in the viewer so you can do replays without creating an edit timeline. It's a form of live editing where you can select clips to go to air in real time. It's great doing replay in the viewer because then you can keep playing clips as long as you want. To make this work, we set a point of interest or a POI at the event you want to replay. In this ice hockey example, our event will be anything that stops the game or when a team scores a goal. Now the first step is to press the go to end key and then go to the end of the current media. Because you're editing media that's being live recorded, you can see the media growing in length right here in the viewer. This media has just been recorded, so let's scroll back a little to get to the event that just happened. Now we can press the set POI key to mark the POI right on top of the event. Once you've entered the POI, you're ready to start your replay. Of course, you'll want to scroll back a little before the POI so you can show the lead up to the event. However, there is a faster way, which is to watch the live video input and set the POI from the input video timecode. In our setup here, we have this switcher multiview connected to our video input so we can watch live video and wait for something interesting to happen. When an event happens, we select the set POI key and the POI will be set from the input video timecode. A nice shortcut that works when you're in input view is to press the space bar, which will also enter a POI. Setting the POI from the input view will automatically switch back to the viewer and then cue the playback point to the POI. By scrolling the viewer and looking at the multi-view, you can see which camera has the best shot. Of course, you'll want to scroll back a little before the POI so you can play the lead up to the event. You can also press and hold a time key and then press the go to POI key to pre-roll by a specific amount of time. In this example, camera 2 looks best, so let's press the camera 2 key. We have camera 2 selected, so we're now ready for the replay to start. When the director is ready for the replay, just press run on the replay controls. There's also a button on the replay keyboard for run. The viewer will switch to a multi-view, which lets you review other possible replay shots while the first shot is playing to air. Even though the viewer has a multi-view, the SDR video output will play back in full screen. Also, the camera that's currently being played to air has a red tally border on the multi-view. You can also do live speed changes by using the fader on the replay panel. If you enable optical flow on the replay palette, you can get some really nice smooth motion if you have a fast computer. The great thing about the multi-view is it makes it really easy to scan for other camera angles to use for the next replay shot. When you've identified the next replay shot, you'll want to switch cameras and pre-roll, and this is where the POI makes all that possible. DaVinci Resolve will use the POI to cue the next shot. Now we want the next shot to start 2 seconds before the POI, so to do that, we press and hold the 2 second time key on the replay keyboard. Then because we want to transition to camera 3, next we press the camera 3 button on the keyboard. The playback will now jump back or pre-roll 2 seconds before the POI and then cut to camera 3. Camera 3 will now become the second shot in our replay. The reason DaVinci knows to do this pre-roll queuing of cameras is because it's in run mode, so it knows it's doing a replay. If you want to add a third camera angle to keep the replay going, then just keep watching the multi-view for an interesting shot. In our replay, we did a cut transition, but you can also change the transition type using the transition keys. When you're in a replay, the transition keys change to become transition selection keys, so let's change to dissolve for our replay. Now let's add a third shot to our replay by pressing and holding the 4 second key this time. Camera 5 looks good, so let's press the Cam 5 key to use Camera 5 as our next replay shot. You can see we pre-rolled 4 seconds before the POI, then did a dissolve transition to Camera 5. A nice tip is to use the POI Offset Indicator to keep track of the playback point relative to the point of interest. You can see this when we did the last replay shot, that the playback pre-rolled 4 seconds before the POI. It's nice to watch the POI offset indicator as it confirms you've played past the POI before you switch to the next camera in your replay. Also, if you just press the camera buttons without a time key, then you can live switch between cameras at the current playback point. That's great for longer events such as fights that can go on for a while, which I've noticed seems to be quite common in ice hockey. So I think 3 shots in this replay is good enough, so let's complete the replay by pressing the dump key. That tells DaVinci Resolve it's finished the replay, so it can go back to normal editing behavior. Now the advantage of doing the replay inside DaVinci Resolve is that you can add the replay into the timeline by selecting the Add Most Recent Replay to Timeline button. Now the whole replay will be added into the current timeline. DaVinci Resolve is a full editor, color corrector, visual effects, and audio post-production tool, so you can now use the replay as an edit. Imagine preserving your replays by rendering them out as a constant stream of social media posts for a global audience. It's pretty cool. So here I added the replay to the existing timeline melt, but I can create a whole new timeline for this replay just by using the new timeline key. Then I can add the replay to the new timeline so it's a dedicated edit just for this last replay. Also, adding the replay to the timeline will keep any speed changes, and you can see them applied to the clips in the timeline here. You can see the speed change on the clip, and you can edit the speed and the keyframes with the mouse. You can also adjust the speed change by pressing the set speed key on the replay keyboard and adjusting the search dial. When adjusting the clip speed settings, the clip duration will ripple the timeline so you don't lose any part of the clip. But of course, you can also trim the clip by using the trim out key and adjusting the search dial. Also, if you have auto stinger turned on, the stinger will play when you press the run on the dump buttons when starting and ending a replay. The auto stinger can use the SDI key output to blend the stinger and the replay automatically into the switch's downstream key. Auto stinger is great because it's like having a replay automation system built right into DaVinci Resolve. Plus, the switcher operator doesn't have to do anything because DaVinci Resolve manages the whole replay. So that's all there is to shot sequencing in DaVinci Resolve 19, and I hope this video was helpful. You can learn more at the Blackmagic Design website.